click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in this video we are going to study what is commutation and what is the process of commutation. When the coil passes through each and every segment of the commutator, the current in the coil gets reversed. The reversal of current in the coil is called as commutation. We are going to study in detail what is a commutation and how the commutation actually takes place. Commutation, the process of current reversal of coil short-circuited by the brush when it passes through the MNA is called as commutation. Commutation period, the period during which the coil remains short-circuited is called as commutation period. Here we can see this is the commutator and these are the brushes which are connected to the commutator. Whatever current is generated by the commutator is collected by the brush and it is given to the external circuitry. Now let us see what is the process of commutation. Let IA be the value of armature current, A be the number of parallel paths. Before the armature coil reaches the segment, it reverses the current from IA by A. After crossing the brush width, the coil current reverses to minus IA by A. Now, what is the ideal commutation? If the process of short circuiting of the coil is completed within the period of commutation, what is meaning of process of short circuiting of coil is that when the current is reversed from IA by A to minus IA by A, this total process when it is completed within the period of commutation, then it is called as ideal commutation. Now what is non-ideal commutation? If the process of short circuiting of the coil is not completed within the period of commutation, then that commutation is called as non-ideal commutation. Now consider this figure. In this figure, there are three coils A, B and C. Each coil is carrying a current of 20 ampere. There are three commutator segments A, B and C. As each coil is carrying the current of 20 ampere, in this position of the brush is totally across the commutator segment B. In this case, the total current across the brush is 40 amperes. Now how this 40 amperes? 20 ampere from coil B plus 20 ampere from coil C. So the total current across the brush is 40 amperes. Here, coil B has just started the process of commutation. So, the coil B is about to get short-circuited by the brush. Now, if you see the figure B, as the armature rotates, the brush has moved slightly from segment B to segment A. In this case, the 1/3 of the brush has moved away from segment B into the segment A. Hence, from coil A, 10 ampere current will flow through the brush, and from coil B, 10 ampere current, and from coil C, 20 ampere current. So the total current of 30 ampere from segment B will flow in the brush. Hence, the total current will be the current of segment A plus the current of segment B. The current of segment A is 10 ampere while the current of segment B is 30 ampere. Hence, the total current across the brush is 40 amperes. Now, in figure C, we can see that the total coil B is short-circuited by the brush. Hence, the current flowing through this coil will be 0 ampere. Now, half of the brush is along the segment A, whereas half of the brush is along the segment B. The current in coil B is zero as it is short circuited by the brush. So, the current flowing in the brush will be from segment A and segment B. The current flowing from coil A via segment A is 20 ampere, whereas the current flowing from coil C via segment B is 20 ampere. So, the total current across the brush is addition of current from coil A and addition of current from coil B. So, the total current in coil A is 20 ampere, whereas the total current in coil B is 20 ampere. Hence, the total current across the brush is 40 ampere. Now, if we see figure D, the brush has moved slightly away from segment B towards segment A. Here, the area of contact of brush from segment B is rapidly decreasing while the area of contact of brush in segment A is increasing. Here, if we see, the coil B carries a small amount of current, that is 10 ampere. Hence, the current from segment B which flows through the brush is 10 ampere. Whereas, if we see in coil A, the total current is 30 ampere. Now, how this 30 ampere? The current in coil B, that is 20 ampere, gets divided into 10 ampere and 10 ampere. Now, the first part of 10 ampere is flowing in segment B and via segment B, it goes to the brush. The remaining 10 ampere adds with the current of coil A. So, the total current flowing in segment A becomes 30 ampere. Now, the current in the brush is addition of current in segment A plus current in segment B. Hence, the total current across the brush is 40 amperes. In figure E, again, the brush has shifted away from segment B towards segment A. Here, if we see, the total commutation process of coil B should have been completed. But still, some amount of current, that is 5 ampere, flows through the segment A. As 5 ampere current is flowing from segment B in the brush, the total current in coil B remains 15 ampere. But ideally, the current in coil B should have to be 20 ampere. Hence, this commutation process is called as non-ideal commutation process. Now, if we see here, the total current entering the brush from segment B is 5 amperes, whereas the total current entering the brush from segment A is the addition of current in coil A plus addition of current in coil B. If we see, 15 ampere current flows through coil B and 20 ampere current flows from coil A. So, the total current of 35 ampere flow from segment A into the brush. Hence, the total current across the brush is 35 ampere from segment A and 5 ampere from segment B. Hence, the total current is 40 amperes. Here, if we see, at this stage, the total area of brush should be across the segment A. But due to this 5 ampere current, some amount of contact of brush B is still with the segment B. So we can say that the total commutation process of coil B is not complete and some amount of current still flows from coil B to brush, that is 5 ampere. This current which flows directly through the air into the brush causes the sparking. This process of commutation is the non-ideal commutation process because the commutation or the short circuiting of the coil is not completed within the period of commutation. Figure F shows the graph for the commutation period. If we see, The total commutation time is shown by the graph BC. AB is prior to the commutation and CD is after the commutation. This total commutation time completely depends on the time taken by a particular coil to complete the process of commutation. Thank you friends for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ikeda and do subscribe our channel Ikeda. Thank you.